Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the next video in the series How can we improve the TillWiki 5 documentation. With the last video I did create a pull request with two tillers changed with about the contributor license agreement. And yeah, now I go back to GitHub. I did sign out, so I sign in with Tilly V again. And there is one important thing here, which is this notification bell. In normal cases, if there are some new notifications, then there is also an indicator that you can see it. But I did click this button already, so it's gone. And there you can see we have the two pull requests from yesterday, and both of them have been merged. There is a little information about the different contributors, also which are part of the discussion. So if there is a discussion going on here, then we can also see the icons of the different participants that took part in the communication. Yeah, we see there's one file changed. This is the CLA individual, and now this has been merged, so TillyV can officially make pull requests and they can be accepted. What else is there? There is a little bit of an information that the branch can be deleted. This branch I did already delete. Let's have a look at the other one. Go back to notifications. Let's have a look to this one. And here it says, okay, the pull request is merged. So this is the icon that it is merged. If it is red, then it's closed. If it's gray, then it's open. Or green, maybe open, I don't know. And now I can say, okay, I can delete this branch. But before I do this, I go back to my account and to the TillWiki 5 repository. So now I'm here. Oops, why does it? Here at my TillyV account. And there are 10 branches. So if I can have a look here, so there is an overview of all the branches which are part of the repository, also Jeremy's, and these are mine. And there is the pull request from yesterday. This branch is still there, but I can delete it. And here is also a possibility to delete it. So I can delete it from the notification here. Which I do now because I don't need it anymore, and then I'm good to go. And then I say done and done. So no new notifications are there. So if something happens or if I create a new pull request, then I will get a new information here with the notifications. There is a possibility to save different elements, or here I can see my elements that have already been done. There is also the possibility to move this back to the inbox again. So I can change it here again. Okay, not needed anymore. Yeah, that's part of the TillWiki. The wiki here, if I create a reload, so I can start over again. So it's only the GitHub access token which is there because it's part of the browser storage. And here I can say recent, and there we can see there have been some changes about the link catcher, the signing the contributor license agreement, and so on. So if I click here, and then we can see that our changes have already been merged. This is the repo of the pull request maker. I think Jeremy didn't merge it yet. Isn't? Okay, here it is. Contributor license agreement. And it is updated. The important part is if you have pinned tabs, you really need to do shift refresh, so that TillWiki is reloaded without caching. So Otherwise, yeah, you may see an old wiki. Yeah, I think that's it. In behind the scenes, there is the notifications area, which is important. Then you can click a little bit around. Yeah, with the GitHub UI, so that you can see what's going on. There is my account. If I click here or here, this is really the branch, yeah, and this is the account overview where we can see all my repositories. And yeah, in normal cases, I only need this one. Yeah, what else is there? Branches I showed you already. Yeah, that's basically it for behind the scenes at the moment. Yeah, then see you in the next video where we will discuss a little bit about the DiliWiki documentation. Documentation macros, documentation style guide, and so on. Yeah, see you in the next video and have fun.